Hello, I'm Sebastian. Welcome to Nine Gnar Trees podcast. Today, I will summarize and review the book. Read, Write, Own by Chris Dixon. Presents a compelling exploration of the evolving digital landscape, focusing particularly on the concept of decentralization in the modern internet. Dixon, a recognized figure in the tech world and a partner at a leading venture capital firm, draws on his vast experience in the startup ecosystem to argue that the future of the internet hinges on users gaining ownership and control over their digital identities and assets. Through thoughtful analysis and vivid illustrations, Dixon illuminates how this shift toward user ownership is not just theoretical. It has tangible implications for technology, economics, and society at large. This book is timely as it coincides with the growing disillusionment with centralized platforms and the emerging movement towards decentralization through blockchain technology. As individuals and communities seek to reclaim their rights, Dixon offers not only a vision of this future, but also practical insights on how to navigate and build in this new era. The book serves as both a manifesto for the decentralized internet and a guide for innovators, entrepreneurs, and everyday users looking to participate in this paradigm shift. In a world increasingly dominated by few powerful players, Read, Write, Own encourages readers to take a proactive approach in shaping their digital experiences, emphasizing the importance of ownership, governance, and collaboration in forging an internet that truly serves its users. I will give you key takeaways from this book. Firstly, the concept of ownership in the digital age. The concept of ownership has fundamentally transformed with the rise of the internet. Traditionally, ownership was straightforward. People owned tangible assets such as property or goods. However, in the digital realm, ownership becomes more nuanced. Dixon dives deep into the implications of digital ownership, especially how it relates to user-generated content and data. In recent years, individuals have become aware that their data is being monetized by large tech companies without their explicit consent or compensation. This raises ethical questions about who truly owns the information we generate online. Through blockchain technology, users may gain actual ownership over their digital identities and the content they create, thus challenging the monopolistic practices of tech giants. This shift could democratize the internet, allowing users to control their online presence and potentially profit from their contributions. Dixon discusses examples of decentralized applications and platforms that empower users, highlighting the need to shift from a model where corporations own users to one where users own themselves. This topic is vital as it lays the groundwork for understanding the changes in internet governance and the significance of user agency. Secondly, decentralization versus centralization. Centralization has been a dominant trend in the development of the internet. Large corporations have created platforms that centralize control over data, content, and user interactions. Dixon scrutinizes the repercussions of this model, where a few entities dictate rules and norms, while users operate merely as products. The centralized internet poses challenges such as censorship, lack of privacy, and exploitation of user data, which can lead to a range of societal issues. In stark contrast, the decentralized web, often associated with concepts like Web3 and blockchain, promotes a system where power is distributed among users. Dixon elaborates on how decentralization fosters transparency and equity, enabling trust among stakeholders. For instance, decentralized finance, DeFi platforms, allow users to interact peer-to-peer without intermediaries, which can reduce fees and increase accessibility. Dixon also emphasizes the community aspect of decentralization, where users can collectively govern and contribute to platforms. He argues that decentralization is not merely a technological solution, but a necessary evolution for creating a fairer internet that prioritizes individual rights and freedoms. Understanding the pros and cons of both centralization and decentralization is crucial for anyone trying to navigate the complexities of the internet's future. Thirdly, the role of blockchain in empowering users. Blockchain technology serves as a cornerstone of the decentralized internet that Dixon envisions. By laying out the mechanics of blockchain, he demystifies how it functions as a reliable and transparent system that can validate transactions without the need for intermediaries. The technology's inherent qualities, such as immutability, security, and decentralization, make it a powerful tool for empowering users. Dixon showcases various applications of blockchain beyond cryptocurrencies, including decentralized applications, dApps, and smart contracts that automate and enforce agreements. These technologies enable users to retain control over their assets and reduce reliance on traditional institutional frameworks. Importantly, Dixon highlights real-world examples of projects leveraging blockchain to redistribute ownership and revenue, thereby illustrating the transformative potential of this technology. He does not shy away from discussing the challenges and misconceptions surrounding blockchain, such as scalability and energy consumption, while maintaining an optimistic view of its evolution. For individuals and entrepreneurs, understanding blockchain is crucial, as it provides them with the tools to foster innovation and participation in the decentralized internet. Fourthly, the future of internet governance. Dixon raises thought-provoking questions around the future of governance in a decentralized online ecosystem. Traditional internet governance often involves regulatory bodies or corporate administrators who set rules and manage conflicts among users. However, the move toward decentralization necessitates a reevaluation of these governance structures. Dixon discusses various models of decentralized governance, including mechanisms of stakeholder engagement, voting systems, and consensus protocols that allow users to have a voice in decision-making processes. He illustrates how this new approach can enhance accountability and transparency, allowing the community to participate actively in shaping the platforms and services they use. Dixon considers the implications of user-owned governance models for social cohesion, conflict resolution, and economic sustainability. By promoting engagement and accountability, decentralized governance not only empowers users, but also builds a sense of community. This concept is essential as it determines how the decentralized internet will operate effectively, tapping into the collective wisdom of participants rather than relying solely on top-down mandates. Lastly, opportunities and risks in the decentralized internet. While the decentralized internet holds immense promise, Dixon does not shy away from discussing the associated risks and challenges. He outlines potential pitfalls such as the risk of fragmentation, where a multitude of decentralized platforms could lead to incoherence and user confusion. Furthermore, he addresses security concerns, emphasizing that without central authority, users must be vigilant against fraud and scams. Dixon also considers the potential for regulatory backlash as governments grapple with the implications of a decentralized web, which may not fit neatly into existing legal frameworks. Despite these challenges, Dixon highlights countless opportunities for innovation and collaboration that arise from decentralization. He encourages entrepreneurs and developers to embrace a mindset that recognizes both the risks and rewards of navigating this new landscape. For readers, this balanced discussion is valuable for understanding the complexities of the decentralized internet and the importance of remaining informed and adaptable in the face of change. In conclusion, Read, Write, Own is a crucial read for individuals who aspire to understand the future of the internet, particularly in the context of ownership, governance, and technological innovation. Those interested in entrepreneurship, tech enthusiasts, and digital rights advocates will find this book especially relevant. It provides insights into the shifting digital landscape, equipping readers with the knowledge necessary to navigate and participate actively in a decentralized internet. As the traditional models of internet interaction undergo transformation, having a grasp of these changes can empower individuals to reclaim their rights and forge a more equitable online ecosystem. Moreover, as society grapples with ethical considerations regarding data privacy and corporate control, Dixon's work compels readers to reflect on their roles as digital citizens and the importance of taking ownership of their digital identities. By understanding the implications of ownership and decentralization, we can all contribute to shaping a future that is not only innovative, but also inclusive and fair. Ultimately, Read, Write, Own is not merely informational. It is a call to action for everyone who believes in a better, more empowering internet. If you would like to support Chris Dixon, you can buy the book through the Amazon link I've provided in the podcast description. After reading the book, please let me know what you think and share your thoughts. See you around.